Hello, welcome to netvn. In this video I show you how to back up and restore Windows 11 with a USB drive. Here I use a 64GB USB hard drive. You plug it into the target computer and make sure Windows has detected it. By default, Windows 11 doesn't let you back up the system to a USB drive, so I use another tool, it's called clonezilla. You go to the clonezilla homepage and download the latest version of this tool. You download the 64-bit version, the file extension is ISO. The clonezilla download uses SourceForge with the right server for the highest download speed. And here is the file after it is downloaded, it has an ISO extension and is almost 500 megabytes in size. Next, you use software called Rufus to create a bootable USB drive with clonezilla. You go to rufus.ie and download the latest version of this software. After you get the two files above, create a new bootable USB drive. You open Rufus software and select the USB drive. This is my USB drive, it's 64GB. Next, you browse to the clonezilla ISO file downloaded in the previous step. You change the label to your liking, here edit to clonezilla. File system NTFS. After setting as above, press start to start creating clonezilla USB. Done, close the Rufus software and restart the computer. In this section, I introduce how to back up the entire Windows 11 system and data. You reboot the target computer and access UEFI BIOS. In the UEFI BIOS, you set up the target computer to boot from the USB drive created in the previous step. Save your changes and restart your computer. Here is a list of clonezilla boot options. You choose to boot clonezilla from RAM. Clonezilla will be copied to RAM and booted from RAM. So you can use a USB drive to store backup images. You set a language and keyboard when using clonezilla. Start clonezilla without using the command line. You create images for hard drives or partitions. Next, you choose to work with local devices such as hard drives and USB drives. You use CTRLC to update the list of partitions and drives. Here I have all four partitions. The hard drive has three partitions and the USB drive has one partition. You scroll down and select the USB drive as the Windows 11 system image store. In this case, the USB drive is the partition named SD1. I will store the image on the top directory of the USB drive. You need to make sure your USB drive has enough free space to store the image file. You archive a Windows 11 system to an image. That means you store the entire hard drive into an image and that image is stored on the USB drive. Next, you choose the source hard drive. On my computer there is only one hard drive. Then you choose the image file compression, I leave the default. You skip checking the image file after it's done, because it'll be faster. I don't encrypt the image file, so I leave it at the default. Again I leave the default and press enter to continue. Press the Y key to continue. In this part, the image of the hard drive will be created. Clonezilla will create an image of the Windows 11 system and store it on a USB drive. Fast or slow is your data, big or small. It took me about 20 to 25 minutes to finish creating the Windows 11 system image. Finished image, I restart the target computer. I will check the results and check the image file, so I go to the UEFI BIOS and start the computer from the hard drive. And this is my Windows 11 computer. You check the files on the USB drive. You will see a new folder appear, its name contains the word IMG. This is the folder where your Windows 11 system images are stored. This image has been compressed compared to the actual usage of the Windows 11 system. My images folder is only about 10 gigabytes in size. So I finished how to create a Windows 11 system backup and save it on a USB drive. So how to restore Windows 11 system from this image? First of all, I delete some files. Here I delete Rufus software and clonezilla to ISO file. In this section, I will show you how to restore Windows 11 system from an image stored on a USB drive. In the UEFI BIOS, you set the computer to boot from the USB drive and save the changes. You choose to start clonezilla from RAM. Clonezilla is copied to RAM and booted from there, so the USB drive becomes a storage device. Just like last time, you set the language and keyboard before starting clonezilla. You choose to work with drives, partitions and images. Next, you choose to work with local devices such as hard drives, USB drives. List of your local drives. I have one hard drive and one USB drive. Next, you choose where to store the system image. I scroll down and select the USB drive, in this case it's called SD1. I leave the default, skip checking and skip repairing system files. This is the list of folders on my USB drive, select on and press enter. Beginner mode. Different from the system backup, this time I choose to restore the hard drive from the image. Clonezilla will scan the images on your USB drive. If you backup multiple times, there will be different versions. Because I only backed up once, so there was only one option for me to restore. Then you choose the target drive, because on my computer there is only one drive, so I choose it and restore. You can skip checking the image before restoring if you want it to be faster. You choose to check the image before restoring to ensure the safety of the system and avoid the image being corrupted for some reason. Press enter to continue. Press Y key to continue. Press Y key to continue. Time to system restore is significantly faster than system backup time. It took me about 25 minutes to back up the system, but to restore it took me about 10 minutes. Press enter to continue. System has been restored. I will check the results and wait for the files I deleted to be restored. Once again, you go to the UEFI BIOS and set the boot order. This time you set up the target computer to boot from the hard drive after being restored. You save your changes and start Windows 11. Thank you for watching until now. Don't forget to like and help me 600,000 subscribers. As you can see, the files deleted in the previous step have been restored, just as I expected. Good luck with clonezilla.